From days of long ago, from uncharted regions of the universe, comes a legend.
Hi YouTube, it's Animated Plastic coming at you with another video review. This time it's the Tranformers Kreo Blind Packs Micro Changer Collection 1. This is an extension of the preview packs that you saw earlier, I want to say late last year. And I picked up all six of those, and what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to do a link to that review here. So you can take a look at that if you are finding my channel for the first time. Welcome, and hopefully you'll subscribe and you'll get to be notified when I upload new videos. So basically I'm taking all the Tranformer Kreo and stuff, and I'm doing reviews on all of them now. I apologize. When I actually got this set, I only got 11 of the 12, and I like to do a review of all of them at once. So I was trying to get that review done, but it took me a while to find the 12 figure. And by the time I got that, the G.I. Joe stuff came out, so I started doing that. And now that I'm done with all those, and I did a kind of a Tranformer tie-in with the Skyclaw, I'm back to doing the reviews for the Tranformer Kreon stuff. Hopefully you enjoy the little stop-motion stuff I do, and appreciate the fact that it takes some time. So let's do this. Let's take a closer look at the packaging and see what we get. Basically, it's the same style packaging as a blind pack. You will see that it does highlight the micro changers, and then it does have the Kreo and Transformers logo. And then it highlights three characters that come in the pack, which is Warpath, his alt mode, Singe and his alt mode, and then you got Decepticon Hook and his alt mode. And it's basically for ages 6 to 12, and this product does not convert. It just kind of rearranges, I guess is what you could call it. On the back, it does show the 12 figures that come in the set, and that is Autobot Springer, you've got Inferno, Quickslinger, Rampage, Insecticon, Singe, Decepticon Hook, Warpath, Dirge, Blastoff, Decepticon Bludgeon, and Arachnid. And in case you guys were wondering, the one figure that I had trouble finding was actually Decepticon Bludgeon, which I was actually surprised. I thought it was going to be Springer or Warpath or Dirge or Arachnid. I was not expecting it to be Decepticon Bludgeon. So, and one thing too is, just like all the other blind packs, it is actually printed on the top. It's got a batch number. Mine is 23401, and then the number you're most concerned with is the two numbers at the end. This one just happens to be 46. At this point, I'm not sure which numbers go with which figures, but you will see in the description below that I've kind of spelled them out just so you would know when you take a look at the review. Obviously, at that point, I'll know what figures are which numbers, and hopefully that will help you out if you are looking for them. I'm not sure if the Collection 1 is still in the stores. You may be able to find a couple of them, but I think that wave is actually kind of gone. And I have actually picked up the second wave, which is one of the reviews I'm going to be doing here soon. So at this point, sit back, relax, enjoy the little stop-motion build. You will see that I do an alt mode and a bot mode for the build, and then I'll go over the figures in a little bit more in-depth review. So stay tuned. Here we go. Thank you. All right, here they are, all out of the package, all assembled and ready to review. Hopefully you enjoyed that little stop-motion animation. Forgot how much it takes to actually animate these characters, just because of the fact that there are not just a bot mode, there are actually two modes to them. So it takes a little bit longer to do. Got a little spoiled with the G.I. Joe Kreon, just because those are a little bit easier. They have one mode, and that's it. So the Transformer ones, you know, I love Transformers. I totally had forgotten they take a little bit more work to review and animate. And that is probably why I did the G.I. Joe stuff too first before I did these guys. So without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and start. Basically want to let you know that I did them in the order of the numbering. So this wave comes with number 40 through 51. And in the layout here, top left goes to bottom right in the order of the numbers as well. So starting with Singe at 40, ending with Bludgeon at 51, that makes a total of 12 characters. So we'll say that there is a little bit more Decepticons in this batch than there are Autobots, but only by one. Not bad. There's a couple of Combiner characters that are in this set as well. Actually, there are like three of them that are in this set. So they did make the Combiner Kreos that came out as well. And when I get to those reviews, I'll actually take the ones that are in this set, which is Hook, Rampage, and Quickslinger, and I will add them into the review that I do with the Combiners of the Aerobots, Constructicons, and the Predacons. So, all right, I'm going to go ahead and get started with Singe, who is an Autobot. He is actually a character I don't know. I'm not as familiar with the later characters after the movie, so I apologize. Some of them, I know all the characters in this set, but I mean, I don't know who he is. Basically, it comes with the little pamphlet that shows you the character. Got him on the front in bot mode as well as the alt mode. It's got the Micro Changers logo, the new one that sports the new characters in it. Inside, you have a build sheet. It was actually nice because of the fact that it's not always apparent how to put them together or how to make their quote-unquote alt mode. So it is nice that they have these nice full color. On the back, it has an advertisement for all 12 microchangers in the form of a checklist, which I actually really like. I think these are really cool. It kind of brings me back to my childhood when you used to get the booklets inside of the figures, and you would know which figures were coming out or which ones you wanted to get. So the only thing I'd say is they didn't have the numbers on them from the preview wave they had them. But they do go in the order from top left to bottom right in the order, like you're reading a book. That's the order of the blind packs as well. So 40, 51, and all the numbers in between. So, all right, that's enough on the pamphlet. And each one of the Tranformer Kreo blind packs come with a Kreo block, which I'm a big fan of. And his alt mode is actually kind of neat. He has two flamethrowers that he... that comes with them, and they're really nice. I really like the flame sculpting. It is the same flame sculpting that came with the Serpent Armor Strike for G.I. Joe, as well as I'm trying to think if there was any other characters that had the flame molding in it as well. I want to say that there was, but I can't remember at this point. So my only complaint about these is just the fact that this barrel is really shallow. So it stays in enough to kind of move, but it's really sensitive to come out. That's my only real complaint with that. He's got the Seeker like helmet. If I try to take the helmet off, his head comes off, so it's a pretty tight fit in there. This one does have nice chest detailing on it. It's got like this kind of, like a flame picture with the Autobot symbol in the middle, which is kind of neat, the kind of detail of a thing. That's the one thing I don't understand about these, is they go through all this work to put a nice artwork on the front, and then they cover it up with a little piece for the kibble. If they would have made this like, you know, a little bit, just not having a piece in the front where you clip stuff on the back, but it had it open, would have been nicer. I probably will wind up modifying these. A lot of people have actually cut them
I'm not a big fan of modifying the actual piece itself. So, anyways, enough about that. He does have a few pieces that he does not use in this mode. So, I'm going to basically transform him into his alt mode, quote-unquote alt mode. So we can take a look at that. Take these off. So basically I put the wheels in the other piece that was not there. And basically you put the wheels in his hands. Which, you know, it's a Kreon, so I'm not going to complain too much about it. This turned around. Because that actually is on his chest. He basically just looks at the ground. And then he's got this little piece that basically patches to the top of the windshield. Yeah. And then you plug these in to the back. And there you have, his alt mode. So, yeah, I mean, it somewhat resembles a vehicle. It's not bad. I mean, for a Kreon, it's, I guess, this is about as creative as they can get. They can't actually transform, but it is kind of a neat little vehicle. It actually does kind of look like a vehicle, but, yeah. And that's actually really not the main reason. Like, I don't really care the fact that they convert. I actually like them in just their kind of robot modes. I actually think that's kind of neat, so... And as you can see, they do tend to come out a little bit easier. So, anyways. So that's Singe. So I'm going to go ahead and move on to the next one in the set. Alright, next is Inferno in the set. And he is 41. He comes with this little pamphlet that shows his bot mode, his alt mode, or what they consider his alt mode. Has his build sheet, which is helpful since I'm not wasn't really sure how they were going to arrange all these pieces. And then on the back is the checklist as well. So, in bot mode, he has his block. Now, they made his hand into a weapon. So, you basically have to pull the little fist out. And, I remember that in the original, because I had Grapple, I didn't have Inferno, but... Basically, they were the same mold, and yeah, he did have the pistol, but he had two fists as well, so I guess it's kind of cool they did a little homage to that. I guess a ladder is a solid brick. He's got some nice detailing on his chest. It's got like the truck with the headlights, the Autobot symbol, really nice. He has a cool helmet, which I think is the same one as Galvatron, so... he basically has a few pieces that you don't use for his alt mode. So I'm gonna go ahead and change him into his vehicle mode. So basically, yeah, the hand was a little hard to get out because it's kind of tight in there. Basically, he just lays down. You put the wheels in his hands, just like Singe or in. Most of the vehicles that are cars or look like vehicles, that are like, whatchamacallit, like Autobots basically lay down to make the vehicle itself. So, and in this one, he does not use this piece for his alt mode. So, one down thing is that I don't really like whenever you have to... puts pieces aside. I really like it when they try to use all the pieces. So, basically, this is his little water cannon, I guess you could say. Put this over here. And basically, you put this over here. And that is his alt mode, which... Honestly, it does not look like a fire truck. It is, use your imagination, you can say it does, but it's pretty poor representation of a fire truck. So, anyways, I mean, I don't really expect a whole lot of the alt modes in Kreos anyways, just because I really only like them for the robot mode anyways, so. All right. All right, next up is Springer. Autobot Springer. He is 42 in the set. He is actually became one of my favorite characters in just Transformers, just because the Generations 30th generation Triple Changer came out, and that figure is really awesome. And I also have the Fans Project one as well, so he's actually really cool. And then I also have the GDO Springer, so I have a lot of Springers in my collection at this point. And I'm actually really happy they made him in the Kreon form. He comes with his bot mode as well as his alt mode, the build sheet, how to make him, and then on the back you have the checklist. So we'll go over him. He comes with two swords and a block. Swords are pretty nice. I think these are the same style swords that you get with the Ninjas and G.I. Joe Kreo as well. So nice use of the sword. They're not bad. They're in a gray plastic. He does have a spinning propeller, helicopter blade, which actually spins pretty nice. If you hit it just right, it tends to spin pretty well. So nice there. Let's see here. Yeah. I've had some challenges with the bodies attaching to the legs, where they're just kind of loose, where they fit in and then they're easy to come out. They kind of separate kind of easy. So I didn't have that in the preview wave and other Kreons. I've just started having that now with these guys. So he also has this like vest to attach his, you can see this vest to attach his propeller on. And if you look at the front, he's actually got some really nice detail on him as well. He's got the nice Autobot symbol. So it's kind of a shame that, you don't get a chance to see it when you cover it up. So one kind of thing that I kind of wish they would have done was maybe give him some wheels and just make a faux vehicle mode or something like that. I don't know. Since he is a triple changer, kind of think they should have made him with another mode with a few extra pieces. But see, you can tell this doesn't stay closed very well, at least not on mine. So anyways, I'm going to go ahead and convert him to his vehicle mode. So basically, you just lay him down. This becomes the tail rotor. And then, yeah, there's an extra piece here that he does not use in his bot mode. Is what you actually plug the swords into. So, and the swords, you can kind of say that they act as like the landing feet for the helicopter, so I can buy that. And then attach that here. And there you go. There you got his helicopter mode, which I have to say actually is pretty good for a Kreon. It does kind of give the helicopter vibe, so not real disappointed with this mode. I mean, even though it is what it is, my disappointment here is just the fact that I had trouble keeping his waist together on him. So that's Springer pretty much. It would have been nice. You probably can take some of the extra pieces you get from the other characters and make a car mode out of him or something. So I may go back and try that here soon. So. All right, I'm going to move on to the next one. All right, the next guy is Warpath, who is actually another one of those characters that I really liked. Very familiar with him. I really love the Generations character that came out with him as well. So he comes with his little pamphlet, his bot mode, his alt mode, iconic cannon coming out of his chest. And then he has his build sheet, and he has the checklist on the back, just like everyone else. And he is actually one of my more favorite of the Kreons, just because I think he looks pretty cool. I think they did a good job with him. Comes with a block. Now, this is the only thing that I don't like about some of these things that attach to the arms. They always tend to be kind of floppy. I really wish they were a little more, they gripped a little bit better. Be careful though, because if you try to squeeze them, you will get stress marks on them. I didn't do it on these. I learned my lesson from some of the other ones I had. Actually, I don't have to take these off. But he has the same head sculpt as Ironhide. And see, his helmet comes off pretty easily. And he has a nice facial expression. And then he also has the vest that covers up his cool detailing on his chest. I mean, kind of hard to do paint detailing on it with a cannon sticking out, but you can tell that this is where the turret is. And we'll say they did a pretty good job on that. So, all right. I'm going to go ahead and convert him into his tank mode. And he did have a piece that you didn't use in his butt mode. And let's go ahead and do that. Basically, you just lean him back. He kind of is leaning back. You fold the treads down. And let's see here. So you just basically take the cannon off the off his chest, because you're going to... And you turn the head around. So basically you had the head facing backwards. You turn the whole thing around, but it's just easier to just turn the helmet around. And then this is your turret. Attach the tank. And boom. There is his alt mode, which not really digging it, but good try. but, you know, like I say, I don't really fault them for trying to make some sort of alt mode out of them. I like them for the Kreon aspect, not the transformation or the converting aspect of him. So, but they did a good job with the little treads. It actually does a pretty decent job. I mean, it does resemble the outline of a tank with hands and stuff. So, so anyways, all right, that is Warpath, and he is number 43 in the set. All right, next up is Quickslinger. Another Autobot from the set. He comes with his little pamphlet, bot mode and alt mode. He has his build sheet on the inside, and he does have his checklist on the back. So, overall, another simple, same figure. He actually has a kind of a cool gun, I thought. They actually put a lot of the extra pieces together to form a nice gun. And I thought this was neat because the fact that it actually used almost all of them in the instructions. It doesn't have a use for this one, but you could, well, maybe not. I guess it wouldn't. I was going to say, maybe you could probably put the red tip on the end of the gun, but it does not fit. I guess you could kind of jam it on there if you wanted to. So you could. Looks kind of weird, but anyway, it looks better without it. So, but yeah, he does have an extra piece that you don't use. Comes with the block. And I actually think the gun is cool because it's like 3-4 pieces that you put together to make it. So they did a good job of taking little pieces and putting them together to make him. Now, I don't know who Quickslinger is. So I can't remember all the Aerial Bots names. I can probably name like 3 of them. So, and I do know the characters. I don't think I ever took the time to learn them. He uses the Ratchet mold, helmet sculpt. He has an orange head, and it looks like, I can't tell if maybe my paint wore off already from putting the helmet on, because he's got a little mark on his face. He does have some nice detailing on his chest, nice silver paint, and a nice beautiful looking Autobot symbol. And one thing I noticed on all these is they all have the square shoulders, unlike the G.I. Joe, which have the rounded shoulders. So basically going to convert him into his alt mode. So basically you just put him facing down, you take his waist apart. Yeah, the only thing I don't like about when you do that is because when you do that, it's always hard to keep the waist together because they tend to separate when you do that. And then, oh, yeah, this is one where you don't use the helmet. You put the tip on, And then you break the gun into four pieces. And you actually don't use the gun in this one. But let's see here. I actually thought it was kind of clever how they did the fin in the back. So basically have this piece, you put it in here. And then to balance the black on the back, they put this piece over here. Then you move it to the middle, and then you can rotate the fin so it looks straight. And so that actually does have kind of a plain looking, I think. So yeah, so you can see that it, I have had trouble keeping it together when it's like that. So, but yeah, it is, you know, plain all mode. Yeah, I mean, it resembles an airplane in the fact that it's got wings and it's got a thing in the back. So, I mean, I'm not complaining about it. I just, you know, it is what it is. You could probably put the gun in his back. Yeah, you could put it there too if you wanted to. So you could actually put the gun into the thing. Instructions doesn't call for it, but hey, I just made a custom Quickslinger. All right, so go ahead and move on to the next character in the set. All right, next we're going to go to Rampage, who is the first Decepticon that is in the set that I'm going to review. He is number 45. Yeah, sorry, I forgot to mention that Quickslinger is 44. And he has his brochure, pamphlet. The front, he is in bot mode, and then his alt mode, or beast build. In this instance, he's got his build sheet on the back with his checklist. So, and he actually has just a handgun that you don't use in his bot mode. Because he has a sword, so he has a couple of different weapons. Comes the Kreo block, and then basically, I'll take this out. He comes with a sword, which is cool. It's kind of like a kind of interesting looking scimitar kind of thing. So I know who the Predacons are, but I don't know the figures because I always wanted them because I thought Predaking looked so awesome, but I never took the time to learn their names and stuff. So it's been kind of a long since I've been in Transformers. Now, he has like this kind of interesting looking sculpted head. I guess those are the mouth, and then these are supposed to be the eyes. Yeah, and one thing I have an issue with too is I have trouble keeping this piece on because it sticks out a little bit, so you tend to hit it and it pops off. So he has the all orange face. So basically, this is the same face that they use, I think, with Quickslinger. And again, he's another one of those that has this beautiful detailing. It's like this lion, really cool, with the Decepticon symbol on it, but it's covered up by the chest. And so it's kind of a shame that he has all this stuff. So basically, since he's a beast, you just put his arms down to signify like a beast. So basically, you just hunch him over. You turn the chest piece around, and then put this piece on like that. And then instead of the sword, you put the two guns in his legs. Kind of angle them out. So, and then basically just face him down. And there you have his beast mode. It's ferocious. And honestly, I think he's supposed to be a bull. I can't remember what kind of animal he's supposed to be. He does have a sword. It probably, you could plug it into the nose. The instructions doesn't call for it, but I guess you could plug it in there if you wanted to. You probably could plug his guns into those ears. So you have a little bit of versatility that you can do with him. It's actually not too bad. I can't remember what kind of beast he's supposed to be. So, and speaking of Predacons, I'm trying to finish my Stunticons and then my Aerialbots, and now there's three companies making the Predacons. I actually really was interested in the unique toys, but then the Mastermind Creations. I know, I'm glad that we have options when it comes to the combiners coming out from the third parties. I always wanted a Predaking, and I may actually break down because he's not my favorite combiner. My favorite one is Menasor, and I got to finish him. before, and I've already committed on the Superion, which hopefully I'll be done with it here soon when they get the last two figures out. So, all right, enough about that. So, but I just want to kind of mention the fact that I'm really excited for a Gestalt that's coming out for Predaking, and it's kind of cool that they got three companies making them, so now you have choices, and you don't have to stick with whatever one comes out. So, I gotta say, it's actually not too bad for Beast Mode. It's kind of neat. I think it's actually better than some of the alt modes we got in some of the other figures. So, all right. Moving on to the next. All right, and next up is Insecticon, another Decepticon in the ranks. He comes with his pamphlet. Shows him in his bot mode as well as his beast build, or alt mode. His build sheet was actually nice because it is kind of got a few pieces to it. And then on the back with the checklist as well. So comes with his Kreo block. And then he comes with the same sword that you get with Rampage. So it's kind of nice. And this is the Insecticon. I believe they're doing a homage to the one from Prime. I don't think this is supposed to be a G1 Insecticon. So he does have these little legs that we saw when we got Waspinator in the preview pack. I kind of get annoyed because they're so floppy. I wish they fit on nice and tight because it would be nice if they don't flop around. But, you know, overall, he does have this kind of, I can't remember which head sculpt this was from. Kind of looks like a Viacon head sculpt in a sense. And then the actual helmet, I'm not sure where that one was from too. I can't remember at this point. So he does have this like back pack. So I'm going to go ahead and take his helmet off, his head off, and then show off this chest paint apps he has. So he has kind of like a insect-looking chest, has a Decepticon logo, so he's got like three different colors on his chest. And same problem with him, I have trouble keeping the waist in when I, just move him around a little bit. So, and then he has a couple pieces that you don't use in the bot mode that you'd use in alt mode. So I want to go ahead and convert him. So basically put that piece together. And then you actually have to take these off. And basically a lot of them are just pointing him to the ground. And then I believe this one faces his chest now. So, yeah, and this one. So then you do this, clip the feet on it. Oh, whoops, I put that on backwards. It's supposed to be like this. There we go. Alright. Yeah, if you clip it the other way, the legs kind of, they point in, which is kind of an issue if you don't do it right. And you don't use his head or his helmet in this one, because you replace it with this piece. And you got your insect-looking mode, which is not bad. I mean, it is, it kind of looks like an insect, looks like one of the big beetles. It doesn't have the wings like they show in the Prime thing, but that could pass for an insect. So, anyways. Alright, so that is Insecticon, and that is number 46 in the set. And go ahead and moving on. The next one. Alright, and next up is Blast Off, another Decepticon. He comes with his pamphlet, shows him in alt bot mode and his alt mode. He has his build sheet. He has quite a few pieces and his checklist on the back. And he is number 47 in this set. So He also has a gun that is kind of like Quickslinger. It's a combination of all the pieces. So, and this one's only three pieces. The Quickslinger was four. And he does have a leftover piece, which is this one that isn't called for in the instructions. But I was just looking at it, and you could probably add it like that and make, you know, use all the pieces, which would be good, because I personally don't like it when a piece is left over. Kind of just makes it something you can lose and then get mad. But I think this is a cool weapon that they put together to make his blaster. And he is one of the Combaticons. So, yeah, we actually got all four of the combiners in this one. I totally forgot that he was a Combaticon, so don't know why I forgot, but yeah. So basically, he has this like Mirage helmet, has a cool head sculpt or paint apps on his head, and then he has the thing that I wish a lot of the other ones had, which is this, which shows off his chest, right? And you can still have stuff on his back, which I really like. That's what I wish all the other ones come with. I'm not sure why they use the vest, so. And he has like three or four different colors, and they did a really nice job on his. Got a cool Decepticon logo in it in the middle as well. So, yeah. So I'm going to go ahead, break his gun down into the pieces, and then put him in his alt mode. And in his alt mode, he does not call for his handgun, but I'm sure that I will figure out where maybe I can put it. And I believe was a space shuttle in his original set. So you basically don't have to take this piece off, but it's easier to take it off if you pull those out. And then you basically use the clear yellow ones for exhaust, kind of like the Lego Iron Man. Let's see, do that. And then you push this one down here to give him that like space shuttle looking, I guess, to extend it. Honestly, I kind of think it was a waste to give him an extra piece, just because, I don't know, I could have accepted it to be a little bit shorter and just been solid. Because now this piece sticks out, and then it's easy to pop off. So, you know, I guess I don't have to do that, but I like to use all the pieces when it comes to that. And this is another one of those where you put the fin in the back, and you push this in here, and then you angle it in the middle to give it the singular fin in the back. So that's his space shuttle mode. And you could probably add the gun here. It may fit in there. I don't want to push too hard. I'm afraid I'll pop one of the pieces out. Yeah, so you can put the gun there if you wanted to. The instructions don't call for it, but this is the thing too, is that his waist does not stay closed very well, so it tends to kind of come apart. That's just something I noticed with mine. But, you know, pretty good space shuttle looking alt mode for him. I mean, I think it could go for a passenger space shuttle. And, yeah, so that is Blastoff. And he is number 47 in this set. And go ahead and move on to the next character. Alright, next up is Hook from the Constructicons. He comes with a booklet with his, or brochure, flyer, whatever, in his bot mode and his alt mode, his build sheet, and then his checklist on the back. And he uses all his pieces, except for the two wheels. And he's actually a really nice figure. His wheels, and he's got another little piece that you don't use as well. So he is one of the characters that I'm kind of disappointed that they made a Constructicon combiner set. It only had four figures. You get an extra Hook, but there's still a missing figure that you don't get, which is Mixmaster. So, anyways, not a bad representation of the character. Got a nice head thing. This one, I think, is unique to him. I haven't seen this one on any other Kreons, at least not yet. So he does come with a blaster, and he has the same issue I have on a lot of them, is that these don't stay closed. I don't know if it's the peg is just it doesn't fit, or what the deal is. Just I didn't have this problem with the other ones, so I don't know if it's just an issue with mine, or if maybe a lot of the Wave, the Collection 1, had this problem. But he also, he has that whole thing with the chest. We take it off, and he has this really nice detailing on his chest that makes him like a Constructicon, the original G1, so. And he has this little, like, hook thing. I don't know why they use this, but I guess it's just to reuse the pieces. It's like, it's not a hook, it's a circle. But anyways, so he has three pieces that he does not use in his bot mode. He has a couple of wheels and this little black piece. So like I said, his torso doesn't stay together very well for me, so it's kind of annoying because he always seems to pop apart when I'm trying to put them together. So basically put the black one there. And then this whole assembly just fits on there now. So, yeah. Well, I have trouble with this because it's so, his legs are so loose into his torso. So it is kind of hard to get it all lined up. So I'm just going to put his head back on. Oops. So just face him down. Wow. Yes. Just having trouble with him. Alright. There we go. And I'm actually surprised they didn't give you like a little cab to put on there. Because he is a hook. Yeah. As you can tell, I'm having a little trouble keeping everything. And you could, it doesn't call for it, but you can put the gun in the thing on the back. Yeah, just having trouble with that. It doesn't seem to want to stay in there. The tolerances aren't fitting very well. So, but there is his alt mode, which I have to say is not, man. It's not very good, and I think this one's probably the worst quality. The wheels don't want to stay in his hands. They keep popping out, so got a little QC issues with my hook. Wow. So, a little disappointing because he is actually one of my favorite characters from the original series, and I do have Hercules, and I have the little micro Transformers as well, which I tend to like to use a lot with my stop motions with the Devastators. Because it's just an easier one to animate. And he is number 48 in the set. So he's the one that I probably have the most problems with as far as his staying together. And moving on to the next. Next up is Dirge. One of the cone heads. And he has his pamphlet. Shows him in his bot mode and his alt mode. He has his build sheet. And then on the back he has his checklist, just like all the other ones. Now, actually, when I first got the preview wave, they had Sunstorm. I was actually going to buy a bunch of Sunstorms and make my own. And then I saw they were making the Coneheads, so I'm glad that they are making them. I'm actually really happy. I have the iGear Coneheads, and I'm really happy with the Masterpiece ones. And I'm really happy to get these guys in the Kreon form as well. So I was kind of looking forward to this guy. And he has an interesting head sculpt. It's all black with the white teeth and yellow eyes and a unique head sculpt mold. But I can totally see them reusing this and making it into Power Glide. So I think Power Glide is actually coming out in the collection too. So his was actually pretty simple. Comes with this Kreo block. He uses all his parts in alt mode and in his alt mode and his bot mode, so yeah. And I've actually seen people that do custom Kreon figures for G.I. Joe. They actually use this head with one of the other helmets, and they get a Range Viper. from G.I. Joe Series 2. So, just in case any of you guys are G.I. Joe Kreo guys, that is another custom recipe I've seen. He has the really nice chest paint apps. I mean, it's got the little turbines and the cockpit that really fits down. And he also has the little fins on his legs, which I'm really think that's cool. And then he's got his null rays. And these were also in the G.I. Joe line. They were actually, they use these a lot for scopes. So, not pretty cool to see them being reused. So basically, I'm going to put him in his alt mode, which is pretty simple. Not much to him. Basically, you just lay him down because all of his detailing on his canopy is right on the back of his head. And then you basically just flip his null ray cannons around to face this way. And voila, there you have Dirge, which I have to say is kind of weird because Dirge had big wings in the back and short wings in the front. So I kind of think it's weird that they put him this way. Probably could rearrange this and maybe make a better recipe, but I'm not upset. I just think it's kind of weird just due to the fact that these wings should be in the back and these wings should be in the front. So, yeah, so. But anyways, I'm actually really happy to get him in Kreon form. So he is actually one of the three cone heads. I hope that they make the other two because it would be nice to have a complete set of cone heads. I'm kind of a completist when it comes to my Seeker jets. So, all right, moving on to the next one. All right, next up is Arachnid, who is actually one of my favorite characters from Prime as far as the bad, one of the Decepticons. I just think her character was really well done in the show. I think she was one of the cool female characters. We don't really get a lot of female characters in Transformers. And I really liked her alt mode as the helicopter. I like the fact that she... I'm not a big fan of the beast thing, but she does work as a spider. I think it's actually kind of cool. She is quite a biatch when it comes to being a really evil character. So really like the voice talent they use for her as well in Prime. So enough about that. She is number 50 in this set. Shows her on her pamphlet in her alt mode and her bot mode. And then on this side, it is her build sheet. And then on the back, it shows the checklist. And I'm glad they chose to give her her alt mode as a spider. But Hasbro spiders have 8 legs, not 4. Just a quick observation. And she has a block. And she is a really nice detailed head. I think this is the same helmet that comes on Knockout. Except for, but she has this really cool looking like head paint apps on her head. So now she has this like contraption on the back to kind of house her legs. And I noticed in the instructions, and I don't know, maybe I'm doing something wrong, but they show them to be like this. And when I actually put them where the instructions show, in the instructions it shows them like pointing like out. When I put them where they are, they tend to close. Like if I push them forward, because of the way that piece is, it tends to make the legs close instead of open. So, it, I mean, it depends on where you position them. So if you position them all the way back, because it's angled, it actually opens them up. But in the instructions, it doesn't show them there. It shows them here, and they tend to close when they're like that. So, anyways, that's just something I noticed, and I kind of been fidgeting around with it. So, yeah, I actually don't know what they would have done if they gave her 8 legs. So, probably a reason why they didn't. Now, I don't know why she has null rays. I don't think she had them in the show. I think she... I don't know if she had any kind of weapon like this. She had like little things she shot out of like webbing. So, but it is nice. I mean, they're purple. So maybe if you have a Skywarp Kreon, you can give him purple null rays. I don't know. Maybe something you want to do. So, all right. And she also has this cool paint apps on her chest and a really cool Decepticon symbol. So I'm going to go ahead and convert her to her spider mode. So basically, you basically got to turn the vest around because that piece fits on the bottom. And then, let's see here. And then you face the no raise up now instead of down. So you have to reposition them. I guess that could be her. I guess that's what they were doing. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's the other two arms. So my bad. I guess they did think about it. And then you connect this here, and you got to flip the legs. Well, maybe. See, this is where I had an issue, because when I tried to do this, I guess if I do it like this. Yeah, see, like when I try to flip it to give it a better stance in spider mode, like I can't get the legs to position the way they show in the instructions. So I'm not sure if I'm doing something wrong or if it's just the instructions show. It shows it like this is what it shows in the instructions. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that like that. So that means that you actually have to take these off and then flip them around. So gotta flip a lot of stuff around. Put them all the way at the end. But as you can see, like if I put it like that, they point in. The instruction shows them pointing out, which is a little bit annoying for me. I'm just gonna take it off, flip the legs. There we go. Maybe it's because I don't have it positioned right. If I flip this up, they do come out a little bit better. Okay. Maybe that's why. Maybe I just didn't do it right when I was doing it. So. All right. So there we go. Yeah. All right. Yeah, that looks better. But now, her legs are kind of weak. They don't have much friction on them, so they tend to collapse. But there you go. There is her bot mode, or her spider mode. And yeah, I don't know. I'm not really buying it too much, I guess. Yeah, there we go. You push it up against here, it makes the legs where they can spread out. But that creates an issue because the legs are not very strong. And I guess if you count the null rays and the two arms, and you call those all limbs, and then she does have 8, so my bad. I like her in the show for Prime, but I'm not a huge fan of this alt mode in this, but I do like her bot mode figure. So, and she is number 50 of these. And then moving on to the last character. Bludgeon. Mr. Bludgeon is the last one in the set. And he is the one that I actually had the most trouble finding. I'm not sure why. I don't know if he's a really popular character or not. I know he's a pretender, but I don't know him. I do know that I got the Revenge of the Fallen Voyager character, and I really like that figure. But I don't like the samurai look. But I really like that transformation was actually really well engineered. I think it's because I really like the gimmick when it comes to how the turret stores his sword and his little dagger. I think that was really clever how they did that. So, all right. And then this is his flyer. It shows him in his build sheet. And then it shows his checklist. And he is number 51 in the set. He comes with his block, and he uses all his parts as well in his alt mode and his bot mode. So, now he's a fluorescent, if you can tell. He's got the really bright green, like they're kind of like a sea green blue. So, which sea green? I don't know. I guess it's just sea green. I'll just call it that. But he has a really cool face. But apparently his head fits really well into his helmet, so I can't really show you that. He does store his turret in his pack. And then on his chest, he has a really nice, some really nice paint apps on there too as well. Or I guess it's printing. I guess it's not paint apps, but it's really nice. It doesn't have a Decepticon logo on it, which I actually kind of expected. But it is a nice looking thing. So basically his alt mode is pretty simple. You just turn the chest around and then point his head down. He's kind of similar to Warpath. He comes with the same sword that Springer comes with and the G.I. Joe Kreons. Basically you just point his feet down, fold his treads under, rotate his cannon around, and boom, you've got alt mode. And again, I have the problem with his waist and his legs staying together in alt mode. So, and there is no place for you to store the sword in this mode. And I haven't found a place to really put it. I mean, you could keep it in his hand, but he would just like a tank with a sword in a character with a hand. So, I mean, you could put it there. I don't know. I don't really know. I guess you could put it here, too. I guess. I don't know. Kind of weird, but yeah. Anyways. So basically, that's his little tank mode. It's basically the same as like a Warpath. It does the trick, but I really like them for their bot modes, not their alt modes. So, anyways, so that is the last one in the set, and that is a set of 12. And I will go ahead and get these guys out for one last shot of all of them in the alt mode, and then I'll give you my closing thoughts. So. Here's Bludgeon, it's alt mode. I'm going to leave the bricks out. Ragnet. Dirge. You got a hook. Then you got blast off. Then you've got Insecticon. And then Rampage. You've got Quickslinger. Warpath. Yeah, sorry, I like to make them look all neat. Warpath. Springer. Inferno. And Singe. So there you have the set of 12 Microchangers Collection 1. I'd have to say that my favorite ones from the set is actually the best looking alt mode is Singe of all of them that I actually surprised. I'd say the worst alt mode probably goes to Inferno because I honestly have no idea what kind of vehicle he looks like. I'd say I really like the cone head. If Constructicon Hook wasn't such a loose mess, I probably would really like him too as well. I have to say that overall I'm really happy with all the characters. I actually know them all, and with the exception of Singe, but I actually remember them from when I was a kid. I remember the characters, and I really think they did a good job. Again, guys, thanks for stopping by, checking out my channel. Subscribe, you'll be notified when I upload new videos, and I'm getting really close to 100 subscribers, so I will announce my contest whenever I get to that point. I really think you guys will be happy with the prizes that I come up with, and once I hit 100, then I will definitely post a video and let you guys know what is coming up, and you guys can be prepared for more Tranformer Kreo reviews. And then I do have a bunch of custom stuff I'm working on, as well as other real Transformers that I will do reviewing. I got Blitzwing, I got Springer from the 30th line, I have Hull of Cybertron, Blaster, and the tapes, and Soundwave, and Sound Blaster. So, got a lot of stuff. It just takes a while to do a lot of the stop motion, so I do apologize that it takes so long to get a video up, but it is, a lot of it is due to the fact that I do stop motion, and that's something I really enjoy doing, and I really hope you guys enjoy the stop motion. I know that I always appreciate watching stop motion. Well, I appreciate watching decent, good stop motion that has some fluidity to it, and it's fast enough to kind of give you the movement. So, all right, guys. Again, thanks for stopping by. Subscribe and stay tuned. And coming up next will be the Kreo sets that I have yet to review. All right, guys. Take care.